Hello, I'm Carolyn Woodruff, Woodruff Family Law Group, here to talk about a reader to ask Carolyn Woodruff's question on the marital residence and whether or not your separate property contribution will be considered. I want to look at two scenarios. In the scenario one, the house was purchased by you before the marriage. The other spouse's name is not on the house at the time of separation. Mortgage payments were made during the marriage, and these, to the extent of at least principal, are considered marital. So we have to look at a proration. And the answer to the question is, this would be considered mixed property. It's going to be part marital and part separate, which is an intuitive result. Proration, if the house was worth $500,000 on the date of separation, which is your valuation date, sorry for the math, but I'm a CPA. Mortgage at the date of marriage was $300,000, but only $250,000 at the date of separation. That means you put $50,000 of principal in the house during the marriage, but you put $100,000 in the house before the marriage, and you didn't get a premarital agreement. So the house had $250,000 of equity under scenario one at the date of separation. That is $500,000 minus $250,000, which is $250,000. So we have to prorate that between the $50,000 of principal put in during the marriage and the $100,000 that you put in prior to the marriage. So in that proration, the separate property is $167,500 rounded, and the marital property is $82,500 rounded. And you would be presumably entitled to one half of the marital portion. Now, keep in mind, my example doesn't account for appreciation from the date of separation to the date of distribution or the date you do your agreement. And quite frankly, there have been some tremendous problems along those lines because of the rapid appreciation in real estate. So now let's look at scenario two. You bought the house before the marriage and you put $100,000 down, the same as scenario one. You put the spouse's name on the deed after the date of marriage. You have made the property, your home, marital property, and it's going to presumptively be divided 50-50. Your hope is an unequal factor under 50-20 of the North Carolina General Statutes, and that provides in the final factor any other economic factor. This would certainly fall into a discretionary economic factor that the court could consider at your equitable distribution trial. So keep in mind, appreciation can be dangerous. Putting a spouse's name on a deed can be dangerous. And not having a premarital agreement can also be dangerous and create results that you might not want. Until next time, you can find more information about equitable distribution and property division at the Woodruff Law Firm website or at the North Carolina Divorce Lawyers blog. I'll see you next time. It's been Carolyn Woodruff, Woodruff Family Law Group, Greensboro, North Carolina. Bye now.